Hi, I'm Jim Vasacek.
And I'm Caden Martinson.
Today we'd like to talk to you about an exciting new product from John Deere. So behind us we've got a Gator XUV 835R. What you'll see on the top is we have an MTG and a Starfire 7000 receiver. So this Gator is actually enabled AutoTrac ready from the factory. So inside it we have a G5 display and, as I said, the globe on top. So what we're seeing customers find a lot of value in this product is they're going out and they're setting their boundaries on their fields out in the op center to prepare for the spring plant 2024. So what we're seeing with this is the boundaries are a building block from John Deere for many new products that are becoming available through the op center. So Caden's gonna run us through the setup and operation of going out and doing your own boundaries with this Gator.
It's like Jim alluded to, you guys can see that this Gator's equipped with the Starfire 7000. What we actually did with this one, instead of just SF1, we equipped it with SF-RTK. So that's a yearly fee, but it gives us that RTK accuracy for these boundaries. And that's what will be a big difference moving forward too. We'll have different types of boundaries that will be labeled inside Operations Center. So you'll have just your basic, and then you'll have your advanced and autonomy enabled boundaries. So that's just something to note. As we get across the cab, you can see the modem. Antenna, what that's going to allow us to do is just send these guidance lines up to the operations center wirelessly. That'll be kind of nice rather than having to do a USB. And inside the cab here, we'll open it up. You will notice that there is a G5 Plus display. And so we put a G5 Plus in here, connected with that Ethernet, of course, to be able to do that. And then there's also an application controller that enables the AutoTrac guidance in this Gator. So that's something in a different video, be sure to check out. If you do get an AutoTrac Gator, there's a couple that advanced calibrations you have to do to get that AutoTrac enablement. So now we're gonna be in the Gator here. We're gonna go over the display and just kind of some of the setup things to get you guys going. So one of the first things we're gonna need to do is just make sure our setup is good to rock and roll. So down the bottom left, we're gonna hit that setup icon. And then we're first gonna go through, we're gonna do a client farm field. So just make sure you got something filled out in there. It's still demo documentation for this scenario. Beneath that, we have to still do our equipment. So there's two different versions of being able to map your boundaries. You can go just off of the GPS, or you can go off of an implement. If you're gonna do a fake implement, we actually have to click into the equipment and add an implement. Here I did a boundary record is what I named it. I'll actually jump into it now. And one of the things you just wanna make sure is that you have other as the type of equipment, unless you are doing some sort of tillage with your Gator. Make sure you have none. Go down and let's make sure that we have some sort of center of rotation. If you want to do a lateral offset, you can, but just remember this is for the equipment. This is not lateral offset based off of the receiver. And then the operation, I just put in transport. Working with, I just did 5 feet and then a manual recording. You can go ahead and hit save then, and then okay, okay again. And now we have our documentation set up so we're able to do it. From here for the boundary recording, we're gonna jump in, hit menu, applications. From here, we're gonna go into fields and boundaries. And then you'll see down in the bottom right, there's a create boundary. We're gonna go ahead and tap on that. And you have two options, existing coverage map or driven standard boundary. Again, we're gonna do a driven standard boundary, hit okay. And now this is where it asks you, like I was just referencing, whether you want to use GPS or an implement work point. The nice part about an implement work point is you can have some sort of guide, I guess you could say, off to the left or right of the Gator, so that if you're driving right on the edge of the field, you know right where that's at. We just have to measure that and make sure that we get that in there correctly on the left or right side for the offset location or the 2.5. For this scenario, I'm gonna just do straight up GPS, which is gonna use the middle of the Gator where that GPS is mounted. So from here, we can hit start recording. I'm just gonna drive forward real quick so that we get out where we wanna be in the lot to record this. We're gonna give you guys a little play-by-play as well here, driving or flying over top with a drone. And so from here, we're gonna hit start recording. And now you'll notice that pink line starts painting. That pink line is that boundary. It's gonna end up being an external boundary. You'll notice that there's a second line off to the side though, that's a straight line. What that is it's just as you come around to complete that boundary, it's automatically snapping together your start and end point. So whenever I hit save and stop, that's just gonna snap together that boundary for us. That way we're good to go. So we're just gonna finish driving this boundary around our store quick. You can see now as we're coming to finish how you see that nice straight line. I'm gonna try to end up as close as possible to where I started. But if it's not perfect, it'll just snap together. And so we're just arriving where we were. I'm gonna go ahead and stop. We hit save. And now we have the boundary saved activated for use. It comes across the top. So now when I close out, you can see we're right here on that line. This is a great way to just go out, get those boundaries driven. Again, this is a SF-RTK boundary, so this one will be good to go for an advanced boundary. Looking forward, this is something that you can do and be advanced and prepared for the upcoming spring if you're using turn automation, any of those at G5 Advanced or what would have been Automation 4.0 technologies. So again, if you have time, it's just a great way to go out, get good boundaries. It's not always great just coming from coverage. It can be up to 3-4 feet off that boundary, or if you're just hand drawing them based off of the Google Maps page, something like that, that's not always the best way to do it. So this is just a good way to get a good, accurate boundary. If you have any questions on boundaries, go ahead and get a hold of us at Leading Edge Equipment, and we appreciate your business.